already set. Case in point, when you consider this war on the Crown 19, how ironic the face of the Crown 19 would be you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. That's no coincidence. It's all by design and nothing more than an effort by the so-called white man to come up against you and justify himself through his rhetoric. And guess what? The Heavenly Father, through his son, is actually going to allow these devils to open up on all of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans out there who rejected that peace offering. When place of repentance was open, you rejected it. So now the Heavenly Father is prepared to take one last proverbial swing at you Israelites, the two-thirds of the nation of Israel, with that sword, which pursuant to the book of Psalms, the 17th chapter and the 13th verse, would be the wicked, which is none other than Esau, the so-called white man. Now, we understand that there's a duality with Yahweh Bashim and Hawashah. So once this man eventually rise up against the children of Israel, guess what? The Lord is going to preserve his elect, which those of you out there who have made this truth your refuge, you qualify to occupy that lot. Which brings me right here to the book of Proverbs, the second chapter. And starting at the 10th verse, it says, when wisdom entereth into thine heart, and knowledge is pleasant unto thy soul, discretion shall preserve thee. Discretion shall preserve thee. Understanding shall keep thee. Yeah, and this is pretty much the method to the madness, if you will. The reasoning behind the Lord allowing access to this truth was to stabilize us.